go.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Fire torpedoes, number one. Okay, hi guys, and welcome to the show. And as you can probably tell by my jubilant, ever-grinning face, I do apologise. I've done it. I've finally pulled the trigger on one of my Grail watches. But yeah, so I'm not going to do wristwatch yet. Well, you can see it there. It is. I mean, the title of the video is going to give it away, right? No wristwatch yet, just yet. Let's get into the unboxing. And well, actually, it's a double unboxing, so very, very indulgent video today. But actually, it's two unboxings. I've made three purchases. One is more so for the channel, which is a G-Shock. I'm still waiting for it to arrive. It's coming from Japan because it's a rather difficult to find G-Shock. The other watch actually is from Germany, and it's a Stowa. So let's start with that, and then we'll come back and we'll do the Royal Oak. Let's get into this. I'll try and do this without knocking the camera over. Very substantial, lovely big book. Look at that. The Stowa collection. Fantastic. A book all about Stowa. This is really outstanding. Love this. Okay, drum roll, please. Pop it open. Oh, wow. Wow. Okay. Oh, look at that. That's adorable. So what have we got in here? The guarantees in here. There you go. It's signed. So there we go. Now, as you've just seen, I went for the marine. This is the what's actually the correct? Yeah, the marine classic 36 millimeter with the Romans. You can have a choice of Romans or Arabic numerals. And as you can see, look at those beautiful blued hands. Oh, isn't that gorgeous? And we should have a display back. So this cost me about 700 and something euros. Now you can even have the movement customized. You can have the little wheels there actually signed. You can specify what you want, but look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Love the size, perfect for me. Let's give it a wind. Oh, that feels good. That is nice. I went for Romans. It's not an enamel dial, unfortunately. It's enamel-like. It's kind of mimicking enamel. I also went for the date version at the 6. You can either have it without the date. Look at those blue hands. There it goes. There she goes. There she goes. Isn't she splendid? Traditional onion hand, a bit like, crown, a bit like on the their famous Fliegers. I will review this. But you know what? For 700 and whatever euros it was, I just thought, I'll have it, you know? I forget the ETA. What was the ETA in here? 2804-2. You can see it beating away. Very nice, clear view of the escapement and the balance wheel and everything. Lovely, really lovely. Blued screws. I think there's even, yeah, Geneva stripes on the top. Very, very nice. No chamfering on the edges, but you know, this is still a reasonably priced watch. Completely high polished. Love the strap. The strap is gorgeous. Right, let's pop this beauty on. I'll be right back. Okay, now there we go. Now look at that. For me, that is absolute perfection. I do have to punch another hole in there just because it's a little bit loose. But look how it rides my wrist. It's wonderful curved lugs angling downwards beautifully. So slender, it's like a dress watch. And that's probably how I'll use it, but this is just a very formal, smart, everyday watch. So this is the first Stowa I've owned. I think that's a domed sapphire. But guys, you know, I'll go through it thoroughly for the full review, but the printing is exquisite. Beautiful pois, hour hands, so elegant. And real blued hands, not painted, real blued hands. So quite a lot of refinement. Yeah, so let's give it 24 hours, see how it performs, and in a month or so, I'll do the full review. All right, let's take it back to the studio. It's interesting timing as well, because the last time I reviewed the Stowa was exactly almost a year ago. In fact, I wasn't intending to, I wasn't intending to buy this. Of course I was. What happened was I was gonna email them, because this, to me, is one of the most underappreciated of Stowa's lineup. Stowa, as we know, is a very historic German brand from the Black Forest. And this particular model is one of their forgotten about pieces. So I emailed them and I was like, is there any possibility I could borrow one for a review? And then I thought about no, because what's going to happen is I'm most likely going to want to keep it. And as you guys know, if I like something, I buy it. So I said, don't worry about it, forget about it, I'm gonna buy it. So I went through the whole process, and you can pay by PayPal, it's really easy. Sure enough, I think it took a month. They specify 3 weeks, because this is obviously custom to my specifications. The website's excellent, you specify the movement, if you want any customization. You can even have the wheels in the wheel train of the actual movement inscribed. If it's an automatic, you can have on a custom rotor, all the rest of it, right? So it takes a little bit of time, and sure enough, it arrived. And so I'm gonna stay tuned for the review of this, but I have to say, it's the quality, it's fantastic. I can't believe this was, I think it ended up costing about 750 euros. So I'm really, really chuffed with this. Yeah, and as you can imagine, a purge, a collection purge is inevitably gonna follow, right? But stay tuned for the full review of that. I'll do it in a couple of weeks, maybe a month. So yeah, let's move on to the Grail watch. Yes, there it is, look at that. The Royal Oak, but this is no ordinary Royal Oak. This is a very rare version. So let's change perspectives again. We'll do the unboxing, then I'll come back and I'll describe or give you my feedback on why I went for this one and not the one in the store, okay? I am slightly nervous about this because I don't know what to expect. There was no other way of trying this watch on other than buying it. So it could be a complete disaster, could be a huge success, who knows? Anyway, before we get into this, I do have to address something. I've noticed, I refer to this as my benchmark. This is actually a Benchmade. I wasn't aware there's another brand. Apparently they're like a ripoff of Benchmade. So just to be clear, my knife check, that this is actually the Benchmade Griptilian. I love Benchmade. For some reason, I just erroneously refer to it as Benchmark. I don't know why. God knows, but anyway, let's crack on, make the first incision. Drum roll, please. God, fingers crossed. I am really nervous about this. Is it the right way? Oh, I could just, wow. Okay. Interesting. It's the mid-size AP. Ah, there we go. It's got that funny clasp that APs have, which I must admit, when I was in the store, I didn't know how to operate, but my God, look how thin it is. Jesus. Sorry, I shouldn't blaspheme. This is what's called the Zen dial. It's quartz, obviously. I think from about the mid-90s or late 90s. I might be wrong. God, that's in beautiful condition. And this is what concerned me about vintage. Well, not vintage, but used APs, is that the... that's just a bit of fluff. Is the whole thing about the AP is the polishing. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to take this off, but let's have a look. Yeah, you see all the beveling there. It's beautiful. My God, clean and simple, and that's what I like. Less is so much more. And that grey tapisserie dial, I don't know if you're getting that, but look at that. Audemars Piguet. Octagonal screws, or hexagonal, I should say, they are in yellow gold. So this is an unusual thing, but this particular reference doesn't have the signed crown, which is a bit bizarre. Let's unscrew it. Move the hands. Wow, it really extends. It's quite difficult to do with gloves on, so I do apologize. Let's have a look at the back. Stickers on the back. Back looks very clean. There's the reference there. Wow, look at that bracelet. It's all about that bracelet. That's what's so important. Let's take off the stickers. I definitely wanted it on the bracelet. For me, the bracelet is part of the charm. This wonderful, oh, it's so slender. Let's look at those edges. I'm concerned about polishing, so thankfully this has retained its sharpness. It's not, from what I can see, hasn't been. Look at that edge. Look at the edge there. See the beveling edge there? My God, could this be the one for me? The gray dial, very, very simple, extremely slender. Yeah, it's a quartz, but I don't have to worry about it. You know, just pop it on. Let's pop it on. Wow. I mean, I'm going to have to remove some links. I'll probably remove a couple, but that's pretty much how it would sit on my wrist. I love that grey. It's almost blue, but not quite. Audemars Piguet in crisp white. Very, very nice. And the fact that there's no date, oh, it's so simple. Sorry, that's a bit of fluff there. Even the clasp is in good condition. When you buy these new used, you see this part scratched to hell, but yeah, it looks fantastic. Actually, you know what? Let's just test the loom as well. I'm just curious to see if it's retained any loom charge. Hold on, right back. I'll just gonna go and get the and I'll get my calipers too. I can already see it's glowing a little bit. Aha! Fantastic! That is so cool. That is so cool. So even it still even has loom on it. Put the lights back on. There we go. Ah, so it's a 33mm. Let's just see how thin it is. Oh my God, 5 point. That's amazing. That is gorgeous. Come on, guys. I mean, that is gorgeous. So I'm going to size it, and we'll take it back to the studio. I'll size it and see how it goes. I got it. And I know what the haters and the Gentry detractors are going to say. First of all, they're going to complain, oh, it's a quartz. Why would you spend money on a quartz, a luxury quartz watch? Well, listen, it's incredibly slender. It's very rare with that uncomplicated Zen dial. It's going to be more affordable to maintain, certainly to service. I already have my haute horology complications piece with the dear old Mooney. In fact, actually, funnily enough, this JLC based movement can also be found in some Royal Oaks. So for me, being quartz is actually a great thing because this is going to be a dress watch. I'm not going to wear it that much. So it just makes sense. Also, it's quarter of the price of the automatic grey dial. The grey dial in the store, if you remember when I visited the AP store, there's a waiting list. I looked on the used market. I still might buy it next year, in fact. But I know for a fact, because of the Zen dial, this is very difficult to find. I'm not going to lose money. So I might as well enjoy and get a little bit of that Royal Oak experience in the meantime. Why not? And the other thing people are going to criticize is going to be, well, oh, it's a mid-size, it's not a gentleman's watch or whatever. It's absolute hogwash. If you know anything about sizes of watches, the mid-size, it's unisex. There's the actual ladies version, which I think is 21 or 31, I can't remember. And also, I'd be a hypocrite if, you know, I extol the virtues of, you know, always buying a size appropriate watch for your wrist. If I had massive wrists, obviously it would be too small, but it wears, I mean, look at that. It's perfect for me. It's perfect. So for me, I really don't care. I'm in euphoric watch nirvana right now. And also on top of that, I get to keep my Submariner. If you remember, I was even considering selling my Sub, and I've made a point of getting it out of the bank. I wore it all week, and it was like a second honeymoon. I fell in love with it all over again. Yes, it's overbuilt, it's a big watch, it's almost over-engineered, you can say. But I get to keep it, and I get to scratch the Royal Oak itch. And also, let's be honest, I've had the Submariner since I started the channel. I started this channel with some Seikos and Oris and my Sub, right? So it would be heresy for me. Yes, I know it's a cliche, but listen to this. Best bezel action ever. Oh, can you hear that? Sorry, sorry, I'm getting carried away. I'm happy. And guys, I buy watches for me. I don't buy watches to impress other people. I don't buy watches to get some kind of pat on the back. I actually filmed the unboxing about a week ago because I wanted to make sure. And you know what? If I change my mind, I can still get the automatic next year. In the meantime, I'm going to enjoy this absolutely pulchritudinous beauty of a watch. What can I say? There's even more of that tapisserie dial because it doesn't have the date window. It's so clean. It's so pure. It's in a strange way, it's almost more faithful to the original. I know the original was that beautiful metallic blue, but this being grey, it's compatible with pretty much any of my attire. I'm happy. What can I... So I'm going to leave it there. Please don't forget to add your thoughts, queries, comments, opinions, all the rest of it down below. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it and found it useful. And as always, guys, I will catch you in the next one. Okay, ciao.
This is a public service reminder for the good Gentry. Please follow us on Instagram, join the Facebook UGWC group, and click on the bell to keep notified of new videos. Don't forget to keep it positive, keep it Gentry, onwards and upwards. Thank you.